is that? A soothsayer bids you beware the Ides of March. Set her before me. Let me see her face.
Fellow woman, come to the throng.
Into what dangers would you lead me, Cassius?
Good Brutus, be prepared to hear.
All hail Caesar!
What means this shouting? I do fear the people choose Caesar for their queen.
As you do fear it, but I must think you would not have it so.
I would not, Cassius, yet I love Caesar well. But wherefore do you hold me here so long? What would you impart to me?
Brutus, I was born as free as Caesar, and so were you. We were both fed as well, and we can both endure the winter's cold as well as she. For once, a raw and gusty day, the Tiber River chafing at our shores, Caesar said to me, Cassius, wilt thou leap into this angry flood with me and swim yonder point? And upon the word, conjured as I was, I plunged in and bade her to follow. And so she did. But ere we could arrive to the point proposed, Caesar cried, "Oh, my Cassius, we all sink!" And now this woman has become a god. Cassius has become a wretched creature and bent her body, and Caesar carelessly but nods at her.
All hail Caesar!
Another general shout. I do believe these applauses are for some new honors heaped upon Caesar.
Why, man, she doth destroy the world at the narrow Colossus. We, petty men, heap it under our legs and find ourselves his honorable graves.
Men sometimes are the master of their own fates.
The fault isn't in our stars, but in ourselves that we are underlings.
Brutus is Caesar. What's in that in Caesar?
Why should her name be sounded more than yours? Right then, in yours as fair as a name. Sound them and it doth become the mouth as well. Weigh them and it is just as heavy. Conjure them, and Brutus will become a spirit as soon as Caesar. Now in the names of all the gods at once, what meat doth this our Caesar be that make her so great?
What you've said, I will consider. The games are done, and Caesar is returning.
Antonio, Caesar, let me have men about me that are fat. Yon Cassius has a lean and hungry look. Such women are dangerous.
Fear her not, Caesar. She is not dangerous. She's a noble Roman. And well given.
Would she were fatter, but I fear her not. She reads much. She's a great observer, and she is quite about the deeds of men. However, she knows no plays, as thou dost, Antony. She hears no music, and seldom she smiles. Such women are very dangerous.
I rather tell thee what is to be feared than what I fear, for always I am Caesar. Come on my right hand for this year's death, and tell me what thou truly thinkest of her.
Pulled me by the sleeve, Brutus? Would you speak with me?
Hey, Casca, tell us what hath chanced today that Caesar looks so sad.
Why, there was a crown offered to her, thrice.
Who offered her the crown?
Mark Antony.
Caesar refused the crown and fell down at it, and for my own part, I durst not want to laugh.
Yes.
For I fear of opening my lips and receiving the bad air.
What?
She fell down at the marketplace and foamed at the mouth. And was speechless.
Tis very like
she hath the falling sickness. Yes.
No, Caesar hath not, but you and honest Casca, we have the falling sickness.
I know not what you mean by that, but I am sure that Caesar fell down.
I could tell you more news, too, for pulling scarves off Caesar's images, men are put to silence.
Yes.
Will you dine with me tomorrow?
Aye, if I be alive.
And your dinner worth eating.
Good. I not expect you both.
Do so. Farewell, both. What fun fellows they have grown to be.
For this time, I leave you. Tomorrow, if you please to speak with me.
I will do so. Till then, think of the world. Caesar doth bear me hard, but she loves Brutus. If I were Brutus now, and she were Cassius, she would not humor me. I will this night. Several hands, as if they came from several citizens, in her windows throw, rings all tending to the great opinion Rome holds of her name, wherein obscurely Caesar's ambition shall be glanced at. And after this, let Caesar seat her sure, for we will shake her, where stays endure. This, I know they say by me from Pompey's porch.
Stand close a while.
She's a friend. Sit up. What haste you so?
To find out you? Who's that? You tell us Simber?
No, it's Casca, one of corporate to our attempts.
Glad on it. What a fearful night this is. There are two or three of us who have seen strange sights. Oh, Cassius, if we could but win the noble Brutus to our
fate. Be you content, good women. Here, take this paper. And look you late in the praetor's chair where Brutus may but find it. And throw this into her window. Come, Casca. You and I will see Brutus at her house. He parted for ours already. It's after midnight. We'll awake her and yield her arms.
By progress of the stars, give guess how near today. It would be my own fault to sleep so soundly. Caesar, it must be her death, though I have no personal cause to spurn on her. For the general, she would be crowned. How that might change her nature, there's the question.
The taper burneth in your closet, my lady. Searching the window for a flint, I found these papers. Thus sealed up, and I'm sure it did not lie there when I went to bed.
Get you to bed, Lucius.
It is not day. Is tomorrow, girl, not the Ides of March?
I know not, milady.
Look at the calendar and bring me word.
I will, milady.
Brutus, thou sleepest, awake and see thyself. Shall Rome accept thou? Speak, strike, redress. Such instigations have often dropped where I took them up. Shall Rome, etc. Thus I must piece it out. Shall Rome stand under one woman's awe? Speak, strike, redress. Am I entreated to speak and strike? O Rome, I make thee promise. If redress will follow, thy will receive the full petition at the hand of Brutus.
Milady, March is within 14 days.
'Tis good. Go to the gate, somebody knocks.
Since Cassius first did wet me against Caesar, I have not slept. Between the acting of the dreadful thing and the first motion, and all this interim is like a phantasma or a hideous dream.
Tis yes, Mr. Cassius at the door. Who doth desire to see you?
Is she alone?
No. There are more with her. Their faces were buried in their cloaks, which by no means I may discover them by any mark of favor.
Let him enter. O faction, they are the conspiracy. What shamest thou to show thy dangerous brow by night, when evils are most free?
Good morrow, Brutus. Do we trouble you?
I have been up this hour, awake all night. Know I these men that come along with you?
Yes, every man of them. Every one doth wish you had but that opinion of yourself which every noble woman bears of you.
Give me your hands, one by one, all over.
And let us swear a resolution.
No, not on oath. What we need any spur but cause to prick us up redress.
Shall no man else be touched but only Caesar?
Let Antony and Caesar fall together.
Our course will seem too bloody, Caius Cassius. Let us be sacrificers, not butchers. Oh, that when we would come by Caesar's spirit and not dismember Caesar. But gentle friends, let us carve her as a dish fit for the gods and not hew her as a carcass fit for the hounds. As for Mark Antony, fear her not, for she can do no more than Caesar's arm when Caesar's head is off.
'Tis time to part.
But it is uncertain whether Caesar will come to the Senate House or no, for she is suspicious from of late, and the persuasion of her archers may hold her from the capital today.
Never fear that. We can or sway her.
Yes, let us work.
We can give her humor the true bent.
And we can bring her to the capital.
Nay, will all of us be there to fetch her?
By the eighth hour.
He'll not come.
The morning comes upon us. We'll leave you, Brutus. Friends, disperse yourselves. All remember what you have said. Assure yourselves. True, Romans.
Thank you. mean you, Caesar. Think you to walk forth? You shall not stir out of your house tonight.
Caesar shall forth. The things that threaten me, when they shall see the face of Caesar, they are vanished.
Caesar, I never stood on ceremonies, yet now they frighten me. There is one within, besides the things we have heard and seen, recounts most horrid seen by the watch. A lioness hath whelped in the streets, and graves yawned, and yielded up their dead. Fierce, fiery warriors fought upon the clouds, which drizzled blood upon the capital, and ghosts did shriek and squeal about the streets. Ho, Caesar, these things are beyond all use, and I do fear them.
Cowards die many times before their deaths. The valiant only taste of death but once. It seems to me most strange to think that men should fear, seeing that death, a necessary end, will come when it will come.
The archers would not have you to stir forth today.
The gods do this in shame of cowardice. Danger knows full well that Caesar is far more dangerous than he. Caesar shall forth.
Alas, my lady, your wisdom is consumed in confidence. Do not go forth. Call it my fear that keeps you in this house, and not your own. We'll send Mark Antony to the Senate House, and she shall say you are not well. Let me, upon my knee, prevail in this.
Mark Antony shall say I am not well, and for thy humor, I will stay at home. Caesar, all hail.
Good morrow, friend. Thank you for coming.
Good morrow, worthy Caesar. We have come to fetch you.
Then you are come in very happy time to bear my greetings to the senators and tell them I will not come today.
Say she is sick.
Shall Caesar send a lie? Tell them I will not come. Cal here, my husband, stays me at home. He dreamt tonight he saw my statue, which, like a fountain with 100 spouts, did run pure blood, and many lusty Romans came smiling and did bathe their hands in it.
This dream is all misinterpreted. Your statue spouting blood signifies that from you great Rome shall suck reviving blood.
And this way you have well expounded it.
The Senate hath concluded to give a crown to mighty Caesar. If you send word that you may not come, their minds may change.
How foolish do your fears seem now, Cal? I'm ashamed I did yield to them. Give me my robe, for I will go.
Caesar!
'Tis struck an 8. I thank you for your pains and courtesy.
So too, most noble Caesar.
Good friend, go home and taste some wine with me. And we, like friends, will straightway go together.
That every like is not the same. O Caesar, the heart of Brutus yearns to think upon.
Mark well the Telesimber. This is Brutus loves me not. but one mind in all these men, and it is bent against Caesar. If thou beast thou immortal, look about you. Security gives way to conspiracy. The mighty gods defend thee. If thou hear this, O Caesar, thou mayest live. If not, the fate of traitors do contrive.
Her Senate must address.
Most high, most mighty Caesar, Metellus Cimber throws before thy seat in humble heart. Is there no voice more worthy than my own to sound more sweetly and great Caesar's ear for the repealing of my banished brother? I kiss thy hand, Caesar, but not in flattery, desiring that Publius Cimber may have the immediate freedom of repeal.
What?
Brutus!
Pardon, Caesar. Caesar, pardon. As gold thy foot doth cast his fall, to beg a franchisement for Publius Cimber?
I could be well moved, if I were as you. If prayers could move me, I would pray to move. But I am as constant as the northern star. Let me a little show it, even in this, that I was constant, Cimber should be banished, and constant do remain to keep him so. Hence, wilt thou lift up Olympus?
Great Caesar.
Doth not Brutus lift this meal?
Speak hence for me! Ah! To intend, I do beseech ye, if you bear me hard, then now, whilst your purpled hands do wreak smoke. Fulfill thy pleasure. I shall not find myself so apt to die as you by Caesar. Oh, Antony, beg not your death of us. Now the pal we see bloody and cruel, our hearts you see not, our arms of malice and our hearts of brother's temper do accept you in all kind love, good thoughts, and reverence.
Your voice shall be strong as any man's in disposing of your dignities.
Be patient until we've appeased the multitude, beside themselves with fear. Then we shall deliver you to the cause. Why, I that did love Caesar when I struck her, have thus proceeded. Mark Antony, what compact mean you have with us?
Will we be pricked by the number of our friends, or shall we on and not defend on you?
Yes.
Friends, I am with you all, and I love you all. Upon this hope, you shall give me reason why and wherein Caesar was dangerous. And that I may present her body to the pulpit, and as become a friend, speak in order of her funeral.
You shall, Mark Antony.
Brutus, a word. You do not consent to Antony speak her funeral.
By your pardon, I will enter the pulpit first. Then we shall show the reason of our Caesar's death. It shall advantage us more than do us wrong.
I like it not.
Mark Antony, here, take Caesar's body. You shall not, in your funeral speech, blame us, but instead speak all good you can devise of Caesar, and say you do it by our permission.
I do desire no more.
Prepare the body, then, and follow us.
Thou art the ruin of the noblest woman that ever lived in the tides of times. Woe to the hand that shed this costly blood!
Domestic fury and fierce civil strife shall cumber all the parts of Italy. Blood and destruction shall be so in use, and dreadful objects so familiar that mother shall but smile when they behold their infants, quartered with the hands of war, and Caesar's spirit ranging for revenge. With Ate by her side, come hot from hell, shall in these confines with the monarch's voice cry havoc! And let slip the dogs of war, that this foul deed shall smell above the earth and carry on men groaning for lovers. Be silent, that you may hear. If there be any in this assembly, any dear friend of Caesar, to him I say that Brutus's love was no less than Caesar. If then this friend demand why Brutus rose against Caesar, this is my answer. Not that I love Caesar less, but that I love Rome more. As Caesar loved me, I weep for her. As she was fortunate, I rejoice at it. As she was valiant, I honor her. But as she was ambitious, I salute her. Who here is not so vile that he would not love his country? If any seek for him I have offended, I pause to reply.
None has none! None has none!
Then none I have offended. Here comes Caesar's body, mourned by Mark Antony, and though she had no hand in her death, shall see the full benefits of her dying. Placed in the commonwealth, as women she shall not. With this I depart. As I slew my best lover for the good of Rome, I shall have the same dagger for myself when it shall please my country to need my death.
Brutus! 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 Brutus!
Stay here with Mark Antony. Do grace Caesar's corpse. Do grace her speech, tiding to all Caesar's glories, which Mark Antony is allowed to make by our permission. I do entreat you, not a man alone depart, save I alone, till Antony has spoke.
Stay, and let us do our
best. Go up to the public chair.
This Caesar was a tyrant. Her eyes are as red as fire with weeping.
There's not a nobler woman in Rome than Antony.
No,
she begins again to speak.
But yesterday, the word of Caesar might have stood against the world. And now here she lies, by such honorable women. But here's a parchment with the seal of Caesar. I found it in her closet. 'Tis her will.
Read.
I do fear it.
The will!
Read the will!
You'll compel me then to read the will!
Some that smile have in their hearts, I fear, millions of mischiefs.
Antony and Octavius have put to death 100 senators.
Well, to our work a lot. What do you think of marching to Philippi presently?
I do not think it good.
Your reason?
'Tis better that the enemy see Guscott, sister.
You must note that our legion is brim full. Our cause is ripe.
Then with your will, we'll go on. We'll allow ourselves and meet them at Philippi. Good night. Early tomorrow, rise at hence.
Lucius!
Good night, lady.
Farewell, good sister. Good night.
Poor knave, I blame thee not. Thou art overwatched.
Call Clytus and some of my other men. I'll have them lie on cushions in my tent.
Barring Clytus!
Calls, my lady.
Pray you, good sirs, I'll have you lie in my tent. It may be that I raise you by and by on business to my sister Cassius.
So please you, milady, we will stand and watch your pleasure.
I will not have it so. Lie, good sirs. I should not urge thee long. I know young blood looks for time's rest.
I have
It is well done. Thou shalt sleep again. I should not hold thee long. If I do live, it will be good to thee. Gentle knave, good night. I should not do thee so much wrong as to wake thee. Gentle lady, good night.
So, their battles are at hand.
I know wherefore they do it. They could be content to fasten in all thoughts that they have courage. But 'tis not so. They would stand and would have pardon.
Stand fast.
Mark Antony, shall we give sign of battle?
No. We will enter on their charge. Make fall. The generals would have some words.
Stir not until the signal.
Words before blows, is it so, countrymen?
Not that we love words better, as you do.
Good words are better than bad strokes, Octavius.
And no bad words, Brutus, you give. Witness the hole you made in Caesar's heart, crying long live.
Hail, Caesar!
Antony, the cost of your blows are yet unknown. For your words, they rob the hippogriffs, leaving them honeyless.
Not stingless, too!
Come, come! The cause was not born to die on Brutus' sword!
Oh, if thou wert the noblest of thy strain, young man, thou couldst not die more honorable.
defiance. Traitors! Pearl be in your teeth. If you dare fight today, come to the field. If not, when you have the stomachs.
Now, most noble Brutus, the gods today stand friends again, that we may, lovers in peace, lead on our race to age. If we do lose this battle, then, this is the very last time we shall speak together. What are you then determined to do?
This same day must end the work the Ides of March begun. Whether or not we shall meet again, I know not. Therefore, this everlasting farewell may take forever and forever. Farewell, Cassius. If we shall meet again, why, we shall smile. If not, why then this parting was well made.
Forever and forever. Farewell, Brutus. We do meet again, then. Smile indeed. If not, 'tis true this parting is well made.
Why then, lead on. Oh, that a man might know end of day's business ere it come. But it suffices that the day will end, and the end is known. Come away.
Come down and behold no more. Oh, coward that I am to live so long, to see my best friend tamed before my face. Come hither, sir, and with this good sword that ran through Caesar's bowels, search his bosom. Here, take thou the hilts, and when my face is covered, as 'tis now, guide thy sword. Well, Caesar, thou art avenged, and even with the sword that killed thee.
Oh, Cassius, far from this country Pindaro shall run, where never Romans should take note of her. Thou art mighty yet, the last of all Romans. Fare thee well. Pray you, sirs, I do owe this dead woman more tears than you shall see me pay. I shall find time, Cassius. I shall find time. Come, Romans, away to the field.
Thank you.
did visit me in the Philippi fields. And I know my end is come.
Not so, Milady.
Nay, I am sure it is, Lucius. Thou art to see the world how it goes. Our enemies have beat us to the pit. It is better that we leap than to tarry till they push us. Wilt thou hold my sword while I do run upon it and say by thy lady, thou art a fellow of good respect. Thy life had a smatch of honor in it. Hold then my sword and turn away while I do run upon it.
Give me your hand first. Fare thee well, my lady.
Fare thee well, good Lucius. Caesar, still, for I killed thee not with half so good a will.
Where is thy master, girl? What woman is that?
Free from the bondage you are in. The conquerors can but make a fire of her. For Brutus only overcame herself, and no man else hath honored by her death.
The noblest Roman of them all. All the conspirators, save only she, did what they did in envy of great Caesar.
According to her virtue, let us use her with all respect and rites of burial. Within my tent, her bones tonight shall lie. Most like a soldier, ordered honorably. So call the field to rest, and let's away and part the glories of this happy day.